Ralph Lauren was born on the 14th of October 1939 in the Bronx, New York City, United States. He had two brothers and a sister and was the youngest of all. He attended Manhattan Talmudical Academy, a school his father had always wanted him to attend since he was a toddler. Ralph later proceeded to DeWitt Clinton High School in 1957, where he had some teenage friends that he lost track with after graduation. His high school days weren't easy for him since some students verbally bullied him. His last name was Lipschitz, which the bullies always made use of to mock him. Immediately after the completion of his high school, Ralph had to live his life combating a series of challenges. When he was admitted into college at the City University of New York, he struggled to cope with his studies. He wasn't an unintelligent boy, yet he couldn't ace his tests and examinations. Plus, being able to pay his fees was another significant problem he usually had to tackle. 2 years into college studying business, Ralph couldn't continue schooling anymore. He dropped out and went about seeking any job he could lay his hands on. With time, he was able to get a job as a sales assistant at an establishment known as Brooks Brothers. However, the job didn't last long. But Ralph was lucky to secure another job, working as a salesman for a tie manufacturing company. During his working at this company, Ralph was inspired to start his own business, making neckties as well. But he had no capital and experience in the fashion industry, which made him scared and skeptical about his decision. When he shared the business idea with some of his close acquaintances and colleagues, they all disapproved. Some of his friends even criticized him, saying he wasn't capable of owning his own business. Ralph, however, needed a breakthrough. His paycheck wasn't even sufficient enough to cater for his needs. Since he wanted to be financially independent, Ralph decided he would break through the objections, doubts, and fears he was facing. After convincing his boss to let him start his own line, Ralph began his business. He wasn't just going to make only ties but other fashion-related commodities as well. Ralph was a young man who loved sports, and it influenced his business positively. He named his first line of menswear Polo, which gained reception from many people. The early years of Ralph operating a business were really hectic. He didn't have any employee at the time, which made him do all the work independently. He also struggled trying to market his wares to stores. Some stores declined, while some reluctantly accepted his goods. After years of consistent hard work, Ralph's business began to expand. Gradually, he hired a lot of employees and the company's sales increased by the day. After launching varieties of well-designed clothing for both male and female, Ralph's wares were in high demand in most parts of the United States. Ralph Lauren Corporation, as it's now known, is now included on the list of America's largest fashion companies. Ralph Lauren, who is now a billionaire, stepped down as the chief executive officer of the company in 2015. He's currently a philanthropist and remains one of the world's best fashion designers. Breakthrough is what every striver longs. Anyone who is entrapped in a particular problem certainly desires a breakthrough. That is, the ability to overcome obstacles and have major progress. However, this is not what you can achieve instantaneously. If you seek a breakthrough, you must be prepared to give all that it entails. Joyce Meyer said, and I quote, "There are no drive-through breakthroughs. Breakthroughs take time. If success were easy, everyone would have it. If $1 million is easy to earn, everyone would have it. If anyone can do it in 1 month, everyone will do it. The reason why success is scarce is that it takes so long to achieve, and that is what you probably don't like to hear. I'm sorry, it takes so long and it's risky." Peter Diamandis said, "Without risks, there can't be breakthroughs. Once you've made up your mind to end your challenges, you must not be intimidated or scared to take risks. Your breakthrough lies here. It's not esoteric to discover successful people who haven't undergone risks. They have to make hard decisions before they could arrive at their destination of greatness. The bitter truth is, the success you desire won't come easily. If you can't fight for it, you can't have it. If you can't make huge sacrifices for it, you can't have it."